The winds hiss over desert sand. The moon shines down on empty land. And long ago, the pharaohs hid their treasures in this pyramid. I was thinking about children's books. I was thinking about mummies. Mummies are cool. But I wanted to do something more than just a mummy, like a human mummy has been done before. And the moment I thought of a mummy cat, I just could see him treading down these long hallways. He's trying to find his princess that he misses, his girl queen. And he's walking through this tomb trying to find her. As a kid, I had always been devastated by the story of Puff the Magic Dragon. I just thought that was heartbreaking that there was this love between this magical creature and this human, and the human turns its back on the magical creature. And I wanted this book to have the sadness of that. There's the same longing, but they do reunite at the end. The magical creature does find its human, and the human wants to be found. They love each other. As I was writing, I was picturing Lisa's art. We knew each other a little bit.
It was a joy to be able to work with Marcus. Usually the way things go is that an author writes a story and an illustrator gets the manuscript all ready to go. But with Marcus and I, we would get together and we'd really talk about the manuscript, and we got to develop the story together. There are things in the art that are not in the text. There are things in the text that are not in the art. There's an extra story in the art that you can only see through the art. I think that it just creates layers and layers of meaning in this beautiful book. Marcus, what was your favorite part about Mummy Cat?
I love the fact that we have actual Egyptian hieroglyphs in our book.
And I love the fact that I got to put actual Egyptian artifacts in the book for budding Egyptologists to find.